Hi, this is Steve Gornson with Action Coach Business Coaching, back with another version of the Jacksonville Business Spotlight. Today, we are with Bianca Evans with Trans World Business Advisors. Welcome, Bianca.
Thanks, Steve. Thanks for having me.
Hey, hope you're having a great day today.
I am. It's a beautiful day.
All right. Well, thanks for joining us. So let's get started. Let's just dig in and let's get started. So why don't you just first go ahead and tell us a little bit about yourself and your business and how you help business owners out there.
Absolutely. So thanks again for having me, Steve. I'm Bianca Evans and I'm a business broker. Been doing this profession for 14 years. And basically what I do is I help people buy and sell businesses. So I work with business owners every day, taking a look at their businesses to see if they're ready to sell and giving them some tips to help them prepare for sale, ultimately finding that buyer and reaching their goal of selling.
That's cool. Cool. So what are the business owners that you like to work with best?
So the business owners I like to work with best aren't necessarily industry specific, mm-hmm. but really it's more important about having somebody that has some good solid goals. Ideally, someone who's done some planning and implementation so that when they come to me, they have a little bit of infrastructure. They have some operations. They have some processes in place. Those are the ideal candidates for us because that's what buyers look for.
So I know we've known each other for a while now, and I know that you're probably one of the best business brokers out here, at least in Northeast Florida. So why don't you share with us a little bit about why someone should choose you as a business broker?
Yeah, that's always a great question. You know, certainly my experience. I have sold over 160 businesses to date. I really care about the folks that I work with. I really try hard to make sure that it's a good match. So those are the kind of things I think could make a successful broker. I have a great support person that I work with. We team up very well to make sure that we can provide excellent customer service. And I think that's a big difference that we bring to the table.
I know. I mean, the one thing I've always heard from people that have worked with you is that you know how to bring the deal to the close. You know how to get everybody happy and make things and make things work.
I'll tell you, it's taken a lot of years to get me there, but thank you. Yes.
It's not an easy feat. So right now we're in a big business challenge out there. The economy out there is really strange. We haven't been in there. So how has that affected your business?
Yeah, to say it's strange would be to put it mildly. So what we've basically seen on the business brokerage side, you know, when COVID initially hit, really nobody knew what to do. Everybody was hibernating. So March and April were extremely slow for us. But the thing that's interesting is that sometime during May, it was almost like someone who had initially turned the faucet off had turned that faucet back on, you know, full stream. So I've been running really hard since sometime in May. I have quite a number of businesses under contract right now. Mm-hmm. So it's been really fascinating to see how quickly that shifted. So I would actually say that depending on what kind of business you are in as a business owner, this could actually be a good time to sell your business.
So why would you say is a good time to sell your business, or is it a good time to be looking and buying a business right now?
So it could be a little bit of both. So what I'm seeing is there are a lot of folks in corporate America that are either being offered packages as part of downsizing, and rather than waiting for what they feel may be the inevitable and losing the, basically not having the control if they're going to have a job one day over the next, they're going ahead and taking these packages from their companies and realizing their dreams of becoming entrepreneurs. I'm finding there's a lot of folks that have been thinking about this for a long time and are embracing this time as the right time to buy a business. Okay. So what that's doing is it's obviously creating an environment that's good for the sellers. And again, I don't wanna make it carte blanche. You know, there's certainly lots of industries that are suffering that we're not getting activity on. Usually it's the smaller businesses that are least attractive. You know, the ones that have a little bit more robust owner benefits or EBITDAs are the ones that are getting a lot of the traction because these corporate guys are looking to replace a, you know, $200,000 salary, perhaps, right, sometimes more. So it's sort of those maybe 200 to 600,000 of owner benefits that are a little bit COVID resistant that are getting the most play.
Interesting. So if I was thinking about buying or even selling my business, when's the best time to reach out to you?
Oh, I would do it right away. I mean, the fact is I have plenty of folks that don't come to me until they're needing to sell, which is fine, or really, really wanting to sell. But the ideal candidate would be somebody who's been thinking about this for a few years, that has reached out to me, that has allowed me to do a free business valuation and some free exit strategy planning, where I can go in and give them, you know, some tips that would help them prepare their business for sale and, right, and to sell for more money.
All right, perfect. So in your business, has there been any pivots or changes that you've had to do during this environment before COVID really started?
I don't know that there have been pivots per se, but certainly I'm not someone that can sit idly by and relax. That's not in my vocabulary, unfortunately. So I took the downtime to catch up on a lot of projects, which included doing more social media, you know, kind of focusing on some of my marketing that I had been neglecting. So that was a way that I personally spent my time when things were slow, but now it's off to the races again. So no more time for these extra projects.
I know. Well, that's why you have to outsource those to your assistant again.
Absolutely.
Okay. So with now, what would you say, what's inspiring you most these days?
I guess what's inspiring me is the joy of seeing somebody reach their goals. So for example, I have a closing on Friday, and the seller had reached out to me a few years ago. We ultimately decided it wasn't the right time for her to sell. She really just wasn't emotionally and really ready. And now there have been some changes in her life, and she's realized that now really is a good time for her to sell. So, you know, it's a very exciting and anxious time for her. But I know that after Friday, and of course, she's going to be transitioning out to help the new owners for a few weeks, I'm really happy for her because I think she's going to find some of that peace in retirement that she's looking for.
That's awesome. So we've worked together for many years right now. And
yes.
So what would you say it'd be a reason why a business should choose a business coach to help them, a business coach to help them in growing their business and getting it ready to sell?
So for me, there's no question. I mean, the fact is, I wish everyone hired you, Steve, or at least some business coach that could help them. Because what I find a lot of times, there are rare exceptions, of course. There's certainly some folks out there that have their act together. But there's plenty of folks out there that are great at what they do. They had a phenomenal idea to start a business, whether they're in a trade, perhaps, or even not. You know, they get so passionate about what they're doing that they mm-hmm. forget often about systems, processes, and financials. So, and those are all huge keys to a successful sale. You know, buyers are looking for some level of depth of staff. You know, the fact is they don't want the seller to be gone for a week or two and the entire operation to fall apart. Exactly. But so many of us get caught up in the day-to-day fires that we forget to take a step back, train the folks around us, create some procedures and processes. And then of course, you know, I can't underplay the importance of good financial records as well.
Right. As I always tell my clients, is the day we start is the day we start planning for the sale of your business, whether you want to do it 1, 2, or 20 years down the road.
And that is the best philosophy. I think that's amazing. I would, like I said, I wish everybody that started a business thought with the end in mind. You know, mm-hmm. I think it's one of the Covey principles,
yep.
But it's certainly important.
So thank you very much, Bianca. As always, it was a delight to speak with you today. And for those that want to reach out to Bianca and just sort of pick her brain and sort of say, hey, is this the right time to buy or sell a business, or contact information right here on the bottom of the screen. So again, thank you, Bianca.
Thanks so much for having me, Steve. I really appreciate it.